This is Tevinter, from well before the last Inquisitor's time. I understand they use such tiles as locks. Interesting, though not likely related to a Meriden. The word for light. It's some sort of clue to this barrier. Not sure how. Indeed.
That's something you don't see every day.
A pair of shrines. This one is clearly Ondrastian, albeit from a very early period, likely pre-divine. But this is Elven, one of their gods. What was it? Every mother finds Druffalo among sleeping juniper groves. G-something. The one with the deer.
That would be Gillinal, mother of the Hala.
Yes! Brilliant, thank you. Oh, that would have bothered me all day.
Two shrines for two lovers. Inquisitor Emeridan and Talana. Maybe Talana was an elf.
Oh, yes. That's good. The Chantry expunged references to elves before the Exalted March on the Dales. They erased the Canticle of Shartan. They must have done the same to Talana.
Do you think this is where Emeridan died?
No, this was a site of preparation, not burial. Emeridan and Talana put up this shrine together.
Look at those flowers. They're not native to the area. What if they were left at the shrine as an offering?
Yes. A night of prayer before battle against the dragon. But then where? Where? We're missing something. What are we missing? Oh, where did you go?
I got Professor Kenric here safely. The rest is up to you.
Lady Harding was quite nimble in the wilderness.
I'll be watching to make sure the Hackenites don't come back.
Professor, look at this. Shartan 10-7 and Transfigurations 10-1.
Shartan is dissonant. And before them, empty, outstretched, lay the land which led to the gates of Minrathus. And Transfigurations is, the light shall lead her safely through the paths of this world. Why these verses? Why would Inquisitor Emeridan take the time to carve this before going into battle?
Gates of Minrathus. Isn't there a Tevinter fortress in the area?
Yes. Oh, of course! The ritual site! To seal the dragon away, Emeridan's elven mage must have used a spell at a site of great power.
My scouts have checked the fortress. It's sealed behind a wall of ice. It has to be magic.
Let's look around. Emeridan found a way through that ice, so that way should be nearby.
find them?
And every lock has a key.
Like these trail markers. Ameridan must have known how to use them. If they can melt through the ice, that must be where Ameridan sealed away the dragon.
I'll follow the markers and see what we can find.
Are we certain these trail markers will burn through this wall of ice around the fortress?
No ice, still a wall. What about that? Ugh, water everywhere. Everything is dank and chafy.
Ah!
I mean, right here, doing exactly this. It feels weird.
Yes, but not how you mean. In the soft, thin places, spirits push with memories that didn't happen, or did, or might. Before the door is open, they could let the calf out and it would always be alive.
Could someone please shut him up? Or I'm going to shaft him in his creepy little eyes.
You called me him. Thank you.